Hey everyone, this is Nick. In our last video, we talked about using the eyedropper tool in PowerPoint to make custom colors for your charts. Maybe pull a color from a photo or something like that. But I wanted to show you, there are some charts where the eyedropper tool does not work. Now, I have a couple slides here with all the different types of charts by default that you can put into your slides from PowerPoint, Excel, Word, all the Microsoft charts. These are the basics. These have been around for a long time. You have your bars, your stacked bar, your stacked columns, your bars, your stacked bars, line charts, the area charts, donuts and pie charts, bubble charts. Once we get to this slide, we get to some of the newer charts. Now in Microsoft 2016 and later, you started seeing these things, these tree maps right here, or these sunburst diagrams, or the histograms, or maybe even these box and whisker plots or waterfall charts right here. Those are fairly new charts since 2016 Microsoft products. But then in Microsoft 365 versions, you also had access to these filled maps and these map charts, which we've made videos about before. Now, those newer charts, for some reason, do not want to use the eyedropper tool. So let's go ahead and let's just say that I wanted to change this bar, this column right here in the chart. We're gonna do just like we did before, format data series, go over to my paint bucket icon in the fill there. We're gonna drop down this menu here right to the eyedropper. You can see the eyedropper is down there and activated. I can go ahead and say, I just want the eyedropper to, or the column to take the color of my canvas there in the background. And so that was a custom color that I applied to these charts. I can do this, I can click through all these types of charts and I can click on that paint bucket and you can see right down here, the eyedropper tool is activated. So I can use the eyedropper tool on these older charts. But on the newer charts, I cannot do that. So on this tree map right here, let's go ahead and click that. I'm gonna click format data point. Let's go to that chart, the paint bucket there. Down here, more colors, there's no eyedropper tool. We cannot use the eyedropper tool with these newer charts. Same thing for sunburst diagrams right there. Let's look at this one down there. No eyedropper tool right there. You can see we do have eyedropper tool for these stock charts. Never had to use a stock chart before. This kind of surface area chart, we do have the eyedropper tool. The radar charts, we do. Histograms, let's see if we have for the eyedropper tool down here. I'm gonna say nope, that's one of the newer charts too. We don't have the eyedropper tool. So that's a really big miss. If you wanted a custom color to apply to one of those charts, what you would have to do is a technique that we did on another video when we wanted to apply custom highlighters to text. So just put a shape anywhere on your slide, and what we're gonna do now is we're gonna fill that shape with a custom color. So let's say I'm gonna do my custom color eyedropper tool right here, and let's just say I wanted it to take the color, I've already done that other one. Well, I'm just gonna do this one again. We'll do the color of the background right here. Because we've already applied it before, but I don't have another image here to pull from. But if I want this, I'm going to apply that custom color to an object that I input on the shape, kind of our helper object. Now, when I go back over to my paint bucket, you can see under recent colors, anything that I've applied as a custom color through that eyedropper tool is going to show up here under recent colors. So now I can use that color into any of these charts. So say on my histogram, I want to go back here, apply that custom color. I'm going to go ahead, drop down and go to recent colors. And there we go. My histogram now applies that custom color, but we can't do it directly with the eyedropper tool. We have to do that little workaround to do it. So Microsoft, I hope you hear our plea. Let's get that eyedropper tool available in all of the chart types that we have by default in our products. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video. Thanks to everybody for joining my channel membership. $1.99 a month helps keep the lights on over here. I really, really appreciate it. All right. I think that's all for today. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.